Guys, welcome again. In this video I will show how to use TP-Link Archer C6 as a Wi-Fi extender. So let's get started. So first we'll check the IP address, because this IP we need to configure our router, and this is my SSID. So I will just check this IP address and just note it down, and then I will configure the same range of IP in my new router. Okay, in the TP-Link router. So this is a range. Now I will just disconnect my Wi-Fi. So now we'll access this TP-Link. So the default URL is tplinkwifi.net, and this is a UI. Here we are configuring this router first time. So it's asking to set an admin password. Here we'll add the admin password and save it. So the password has been set. Now we'll re-log in to the router. So here we have successfully logged in. Now we'll go to the advanced section and click on the network. So here in the network section, we'll add the IP address, so in future we can access via this IP. So click on LAN and set IP according to our existing Wi-Fi router IP or Wi-Fi. Here I am setting 100.111. So it's not exist in my network. Then we have to save. To apply these changes, router will reboot and it will prompt again to login. Now we'll add the password and login. Once login, again go to the advanced, click on the network and verify the IP address. In future, if any issue, we can connect to the laptop and again access via this IP address. Now we'll go to the DHCP server and we'll disable it, because our existing router have already configured a DHCP server. So we'll uncheck it and save. Once the changes apply, we'll go to the Wi-Fi configuration. This is the optional steps. We can skip if we don't need to change the SSID. This is the default SSID. We can change according to our network or according to our need. Here I'm providing the home 10. This is my new SSID. So here default security is WPA2 personal. Now we'll change the password. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's a remember for me. You can set any password that can be easily remember for you. Now here I will change the channel. So I'm setting the channel 1 and save it. Once successfully save, scroll down and go to the system tools. In system tools, we'll again go to the system parameters. In system parameter, we'll scroll down and find the WDS. This TP-Link router capable to just connect 2.4 and 5 GHz both SSID. So here I have only 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network. So I will check on enable WDS bridging and click on survey. If SSID is hidden, we can type manually. Either it will search. So here we have 3 SSID. Home and home ext, both is on same Wi-Fi router, so we can choose one home and type the password. So here we have enabled the bridging over the Wi-Fi. Now we added this SSID and just click on save. So it will take a few seconds. Now we'll just go to this our Wi-Fi manager and find the SSID which we enabled via TP-Link. So just click on it to connect. Then we'll add the password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Click on next. It will take a few seconds and now it's connected. Now we'll open the new tab and just open the fast.com to check the internet speed. I have 15 Mbps plan and I'm getting a proper speed. So thanks for the watching.